Good afternoon, guys. Hey, it's your boy, Pretty Tony, a.k.a. T-Double, a.k.a. Pretty Thrill, a.k.a. the new Tony's Note. Hey, I got to get all my aliases in. I got to get all my personalities in. Back with another New Millennium Fit Nation recipe vlog. Coming at you again today with my chef, my resident blogger chef, Miss Claudine. Hi, darling. With Fancy's Personal Chef Service, we're coming at you again with another recipe. What are we fixing today, darling?
We are fixing black bean enchiladas.
Black bean enchiladas. Enchiladas, we have it right here. Looks, hey, like always, like all the dishes Claudine fixed, looks magnificent, man. I'm ready to get jumping into it. So, hey, we're going to take this break. We're going to come back and we're going to get started with the black bean enchilada dish. Dish. Hey, I'm ready to jump into this, get my little chef for ID. You know your boy tightening up his skills, you know what I mean, my skill set. So, hey, let's get this started. Let me learn a little something here.
Okay, here we go. First we're going to make what's called a ranchero sauce, kind of a basic sauce. And we're going to start with putting a couple of chipotles, two of those hot little chili peppers in the blender. And this is going to give it spiciness.
No, your boy likes the spice.
And then we're going to put a cup of water in there. So let me get a little. You can fill that up and put a cup of water in there. We're not measuring today. Yeah, just put water in here. And then we're going to dump it in the blender. You can get dried chilies and then boil them and all that, but we want to make it easy for y'all, so we can do that.
Maybe just yeah, quick fix.
Yeah. Okay, that's great. Okay, so now we're going to let this sit for a minute, and we're going to go over to the skillet, and we're going to saute some onions and garlic. So there's some oil right here.
A little bit of oil in the saute pan. We're going to saute the onions and the garlic so that they're just a little bit soft and they're not raw in the sauce. And so we're going to take about half of this garlic. I would say it's a couple tablespoons. We're going to make a serving for three people. And so that's the serving that we're going to do. So we're going to take a couple of tablespoons of garlic. And cooking is not really a measuring like baking is. So if you like garlic, you can add more garlic.
I know, boy. I come here.
Yeah, it's
jumping out, so I can't do it all the way on that one.
Can't do it. Salt thing and climbing like.
Yeah, hey, I heard women like this. So.
So you can be like.
And now you can do your salt trick.
Oh, okay. What happened with the music? When you record, we can't get the music.
So we're gonna saute this. You'll kind of see the onions will get a little bit translucent, like they get kind of clear a little. Just to soften them so they're not as raw. So now we're going to put a cup of vegetable broth, and you can use chicken broth. This is kind of a vegetarian dish, but you can also, if you're not vegetarian, you want to do it lower. You want to get the height. All of it.
All of it.
All of it, yeah. Awesome. So if you're vegetarian, use vegetable broth. If you're not, you can use chicken broth. And if all you have in your fridge is beef broth, you can use that too.
This is tomato paste you can get in a little squeeze. It's kind of concentrated in a squeeze bottle. Or you can use a tomato paste that's in a little can. I'd recommend getting low sodium so you're not adding more salt to the dish.
Stir it up in there.
And then while Tony's stirring that, I'm going to cut up oregano. You can use dried oregano if you like. Just want to use less of it. It's dried. We're going to put in 1 tablespoon of fresh oregano.
Them steady stirring?
Yes.
We're getting a stir on. Luckily, we're not in the hood. Get my stir on in the hood and give me a shot.
And then we're going to use brown cumin.
Brown what?
Cumin.
Oh, okay.
It's called cumin, not some other.
Yeah, I said we ain't doing no cannibal stuff around here. No, God, no. Now we ain't eating nothing. It ain't supposed to be eight up in here.
Okay, so you don't have to cook that long, and you don't want to cook it too long because it'll reduce the broth that was in here. Because we're going to use that. It's going to be a good volume for the sauce. So we can take it off the fire now. And you're going to pour it in with the chipotle. That goes right in there. And this is a nice light sauce rather than a creamy. I mean, creamy's good, but this is a lighter version of doing enchiladas where you don't have the cream and everything.
And the aroma is so thick.
So then we're gonna turn this blender on high.
Okay.
Okay, so now we're going to let that sit for a minute, and then we're going to make the filling for the enchiladas. So we need this bowl, and then I actually ended up looking when I got the black beans and decided to get the organic. These were 99 cents, like comparable to like the regular canned black beans. But this one has 125 milligrams of sodium, and the other ones were like 370 to 400 milligrams. So when you're buying canned items to preserve it, they put sodium in it. So just kind of check the sodium content.
Yeah, we want to reduce our sodium intake. It takes in our water as well too. So we want to make sure that we reduce our sodium intake. It's very important to try to get as less sodium into your body as possible. So we don't want to retain water.
And so we already opened up a can of black beans. We're using half a can. And then you can get a reduced fat cheddar cheese or Mexican cheese. And we're going to put maybe my handful or your handful of cheese.
I like cheese too, so we're gonna go with my handful.
But we do put more cheese on it at the end. Okay, so then we're gonna put some chopped green onions. Yeah, we can do another one too.
I tell you, it's cilantro. I'll add.
Okay, so we're gonna mix it up. So then we're gonna start filling the enchiladas. And these are corn tortillas. You can heat them up a little bit, warm them up if you'd like at first. We're just gonna fill these with about 2 to 3 tablespoons of the bean mixture. And before we put that down, we're going to put a little bit of sauce.
So?
Yeah.
Not so. Corn, wheat, spinach, tomatoes, corn, spinach.
And it might take 2 people to hold the enchilada. So we kind of did a theme today, since it's Valentine's Day, we, you know, have the red sauce for the enchiladas, and we kind of did our red theme near the plating and everything, so.
Happy Valentine's Day. Happy Valentine's Day, dear. Mwah.
She's behind the camera.
And we're keeping you guys holistically healthy, looking good, feeling good, smelling good. We want all good around here. Everything to be good.
So Tony, I just wanted to see if you could just elaborate on, you know, beans being an alternative protein source rather than just chicken and those kind of
ingredients. Now, lung beans are the best. Especially for vegetarians, it's the only way vegetarians can get their protein, their one source, because you can get also eggs, a little bit from milk, but mainly you're going to get it from lima beans or peanuts, like different kind of avocados or something like that, or beans, black beans, pinto beans, different kind of lima beans. The last dish that we fixed for you guys,
quinoa.
Things such as that. So we're finding out a lot of different alternatives to get you your protein source. So all my vegetarians and vegans, you guys, you know, this is a great dish for you guys. Like I said, it's no meat, it's all black beans.
Awesome. You want to try to cover all of the enchilada. Okay, so let's finish it with a little bit more cheese. You know Tony likes cheese.
Oh, you boy love cheese.
And you can use a Mexican cheese, there's like cocada cheese, cocada, something like that. Different kinds of other cheeses. Okay, so now we're gonna pop this in the oven at 350 for 15 minutes or until heated through. And then we'll wait for that to get done.
So while we wait for that to get done, we'll be right back. grades. Came out looking beautiful. So now is the moment of truth. It's time for your boy to dive in and see what it tastes like. Got a nice easy cut to it. Again, we've outdone ourselves. We've totally outdone ourselves here. Girl, you are the woman. The woman behind the fork.
That's going to be my new motto.
It is. It's the woman behind the fork. Boy, this is good. Did my camera woman want any? Since my last camera person was so adamant they wanted to get their voices on tape. So this is really good, though.
And the white stuff on top is sour cream. You just thin it out with a little bit of milk. And you just drizzle it on there. So that's what that is.
Keep on going. Alright, guys. You see the recipe. Put it together for you guys. Quick, fast, simple, very healthy. Black bean enchilada dish. Again, Chef Claudine of Fancy's Personal. Let me be out.
Thank you. Please.
Thank you to my camera woman. Again, gotta give big kudos to my chef, my resident blog chef, Claudine of Fancy. Claudine of Fancy's Personal Chef Service. Make sure you guys get in touch with her. Go ahead and get out.
My email is fancyspersonalchefservices@gmail.com.
Have no reason, guys, like I told you guys. Here in 2015, we're eliminating all excuses. You have no reason to have any excuses. This is your boy, Tony Willis, with New Lineage Fit Nation, with my chef, my resident blog chef, and we're out.